Well, welcome to English Composition. I'm Michael Chang. I'm here with Cher Chen today.
各位同学大家好，欢迎来到英文作文课程。我是 Cher， 在我身边的是郑老师。
And welcome to the very last lesson in our course. And today for lesson 18, we're going to learn a little bit about proverbs, and then we're going to write an essay that uses detailed examples to support a proverbs teachings.
好，恭喜各位同学，今天我们已经来到本学期最后一个单元了。那这个单元呢，我们要将各位同学呢，要来学习一些所谓的谚语跟格言，然后呢，我们会练习写一篇短文，来举例佐证谚语中的一些教诲。
Right. And we're going to start by learning a little bit about, a little more about Proverbs in our writing focus section.
好，那在我们今天的写作重点单元部分呢，我们会先花一点时间来为各位同学讲解一下什么叫做谚语格言。
Now, Proverbs are short sayings that are very popular in a culture.And they'll be familiar to almost everyone in that culture. And in fact, some proverbs can be familiar to people from different cultures. And this means that the same proverb also often appears in different languages.
好，所谓的谚语跟格言呢，也就是在一个国家的文化之中很受欢迎的话语。哦，那人们呢，对于他的国家的一些谚语格言，通常都能够朗朗上口。哦，那事实上呢，有一些谚语啊，甚至是跨文化的。哦，这也代表着说，有一些谚语呢，它是以不同的语言是出现的。
Now, a proverb is meant to teach people a traditional piece of wisdom. And there might be a proverb that can give you advice on how to deal with almost any kind of sort of situation.
好，所谓的谚语呢，它就是为了要去呈现一些传统的智慧而流传下来的一些教诲。那通常各种不一样的情况呢，都会有不一样的谚语可以配合来教你怎么样去应对。
And however, a funny thing about proverbs is that they might contradict each other.
好，但是呢，关于谚语啊，有些事情很有趣哦。你会发现有一些谚语呢，其实是互相抵触的。
And we also said earlier that proverbs are a traditional, or they teach you a traditional piece of information. And this means that proverbs are wise sayings that have been passed down from generation to generation.
好，我们刚刚才提到过说呢，谚语呢是为了要教导你一些传统的这些智慧哦。那这也就代表着说呢，这些非常有智慧的一些说辞呢，是跟着年代哦，这样一代用一代的传得下来的。
And because these proverbs originated so long ago, in a time maybe when life was very different than how it is now, people in our modern society may find these old proverbs hard to understand.
好，那当然呢，因为它是一代接着一代流传下来的。那当时呢，哦，在很久很久以前，它的情况跟现在应该是大不相同的。那也因此呢，有一些谚语格言哦，到了现在这个年代，感觉好像哎，有点格格不入。
And so we're going to explain the meaning of a few common proverbs to you during the lesson.
好，那我们今天呢，在这一课当中呢，我们会为各位同学介绍一些常听见的谚语格言。
And we're going to start with a very common proverb called a stitch in time saves nine.
好，那我们首先呢，先用这一句谚语作为开始哦。那这句谚语各位同学可以看到叫做 a stitch in time save nine。我们如果呢把它用这个很直截了当的中文翻译的话，是代表着说，哎，你这一针呢，哦，这个及时的哦，这一针能够胜过你花了九针的时间去做裁缝。哦，那这是什么意思呢？我们中文里面哦有一个四个字的成语叫做防微杜渐哦，也就是说呢，当你一开始哦就开始去这个及时的去完成这个工作的话，你就可以省掉很多很多哦，在另外必须要花费的时间跟心力。
Right now, instead of just telling you what this proverb means, we're going to show you through a little skit.
好，那我刚刚这样讲解，各位同学觉得你觉得还不够贴切哦。那接下来我们看一小段短片，来让各位同学更能够理解这句谚语格言的意思。
Looks like it's been a pretty good day. Well, Sophie, looks like it's time to go work on the farm.
Wait a moment, Michael. There's a rip on your shirt. Let me fix it before you go.
No time. Can't you hear the cow mooing outside? Gotta go milk her right away.
You don't let me fix it right now. It's gonna turn into a larger rip.
Oh, don't worry. Be happy. I'll be careful. You can fix it later.
What did I do to your shirt?
I didn't do anything. I was just working on the farm, and every time I moved my arm, the rip got bigger and bigger.
I told you to let me fix it before you left. I could have fixed it with just one stitch. Now it's going to take so much more work to do.
I'm sorry.
You should have listened to your grandma. She always said they should take care of problems right away. Don't you remember what she used to say?
A stitch in time saves nine.
All right, so we will learn more about some other proverbs later. But first, let's take the proverb from this skit and form an essay around it.
好，那待会儿呢，就像我们答应各位同学的，会教导各位同学更多的其他谚语格言哦。不过首先呢，我们先用我们看到的、学到的这一个谚语格言哦，来写一篇文章。
Now our essay is going to be an example essay, and so this means that we need to think of some examples to show what this proverb means.
好，那我们今天要学习的呢，哦，是写作所谓的范例文，那也就是代表着呢，我们需要有一些所谓的例子哦，来去阐述这个格言的真正的意义。
Now, our example can show what the original meaning of this proverb is, but we should also find some examples that use the proverb in a more contemporary setting.
那当然啦，我们刚刚的例子呢，我刚刚短片中的例子，当然是可以用来解释这一个哦格言的。但是呢，我们也希望能够找到一些更符合现代这个时代的哦这样的例子哦来解释。
And so now, first of all, the main point of this proverb, a stitch in time saves nine, is that we should not procrastinate.
好，那当然，这个谚语呢，首先告诉我们的就是我们绝对哦，凡事不可拖延。
And procrastinate is one of the vocabulary words in this chapter, and it means to put off or delay something that you should do until a later time.
Procrastinate 这个字、哦、各位同学、哦、应该要特别学习一下、哦、它是这一课的、哦、特别列出来的一个单字，它代表的意思呢，就是你让某些事情去延迟了、哦、那其实你应该要早点完成的。
Alright, so now let's find out, for example, Cher, do you ever procrastinate?
Actually, I never. So, how about you?
I procrastinate all the time, and this is probably one of my worst qualities.
好，那刚刚老师问我说，哎，我有没有这样子一个拖延事情的经验啊？其实呢，我啊，就做事还蛮有条理的哦，我好像没有这样的经验哦。那我反问老师之后，哎，老师说，其实啊，凡事拖延，这就是他的这个人性很大的一个弱点啊。
And then one reason I love working with Cher, she actually never procrastinates, is always done early.
那老师也帮我做了一个见证啊。哦，老师说呢，他跟我一起工作的时候呢，我总是可以把事情呢及早的完成哦，至少一定会在准时的完成哦，那真的是没有拖延的。
Okay. All right, so let me tell you a procrastination story, and the story that I have is actually right from the writing model, and this is a real story where I was actually working and I heard a weird sound coming from my computer, but I just kind of ignored it until finally the sound stopped. But then I found that the top of my computer was getting very, very hot. And so then I was very worried and actually had to take it in. I had to finish working on a project and then take my computer in to get fixed.
好，那这实际上呢，哦，老师有一个很棒的故事哦。这个故事呢，也写在我们的写作范例里面哦，就提到说，老师呢一开始听到他的电脑里面发出一些怪声的时候，他没有及时的处理，等到要处理的时候呢，已经太迟了。
All right, and so we have this story, and we're going to learn a bit more about proverbs later, and we're going to learn a bit more about procrastinating. But before we do that, let's take a break now.
好，那我们现在已经知道我们的例子要写些什么了。哦，那我们待会还会学习更多关于格言的部分。不过首先我们先休息一下，待会再回来。
Okay, welcome back.
好，欢迎各位同学回来。
All right, earlier we saw a skit about the proverb, a stitch in time saves nine, and we also shared our own procrastination experience.
好，那我们刚刚呢，哦，已经为各位同学哦播放了一个短片，来阐述什么叫做防微杜渐哦，也就是刚刚那一句英文的谚语哦。那当然，我跟老师呢也就各自做了一些哦我们的一些经验。
And then I told how I didn't fix the fan of my computer, and then it had some problems and it broke down.
好，那老师也提到了，就是因为他没有因为电脑发出怪声，就赶快去维修他电脑里面的风扇，而导致呢最后整台电脑就是坏掉了。
And so now we're going to use these examples, and we're going to create an essay, an example essay that explains what the proverb "a stitch in time saves nine" means.
好，那既然我没有例子，老师却举了一个很棒的例子，现在呢，我们就用老师的这个例子呢，来写我们的这一课的写作范例。那我们会呢，用写作范例来阐述怎么样去写作一篇所谓的范例文。
And so the first thing that we want to do is we want to write our thesis statement, which will explain what the goal of our essay is.
好，那当然，首先我们先从把主旨陈述哦，来这个写出来作为开始，这样我们可以去很清楚的知道这篇文章的写作目的。
Right, and our thesis statement can be something like this. I have many experiences that make me believe that a stitch in time saves nine is a really good piece of advice.
好，那我们的主旨陈述呢，可能会写这样子的句子哦。那我有非常多的经验，让我去相信所谓防微杜渐是一个很棒的忠告。
And now, since the basic message of this proverb is that it's not good to procrastinate, we can use our conclusion to say what we learned from this proverb.
好，那既然呢，这个谚语哦，主要就是告诉我们说，凡事不要拖延。那在结尾的部分呢，我们也可以再一次的加强这个概念。
And so therefore, we can write a conclusion like this one: I must stop procrastinating.
好，那结尾呢，我们可以就写这样非常清楚了当的说，我一定要停止拖延。
All right, so now that we know where we want to start our essay and where we're going to finish our essay, we can make an outline for our entire essay.
好，那现在既然我们已经有了开头跟结尾，那接下来呢，我们就可以把这个整篇文章通篇的大纲写出来，让我们看得很清楚。
All right, so now let's start with our introductory paragraph.
好，我们首先呢，先从这开头引言段落开始。
And so in this paragraph, first we'll tell what proverb we're going to write about.
好，那首先在开头引言段落，我们要先点出我们今天要讲的这个谚语格言是什么。
Then we'll explain the meaning of the proverb.
那接下来解释它的意义。
And then we'll have our thesis statement.
然后我们接下来就把我们刚刚写的主旨陈述把它放进来。
Right. Now next we're going to outline the body paragraphs of our essay.
好，那接下来呢，在这个主体的段落部分呢，我们也要来把它大纲条列出来。
And in our body paragraphs, we want to give clear and specific examples.
好，那当然呢，在这个主体段落的部分，我们就是要提出非常清楚且明确的例子了。
And so we just try to make examples something that our readers can really relate to.
好，所谓清楚且明确的例子呢，当然就是指说这样的例子呢，是你的读者呢可以感同身受的。
And we should also give enough details in these examples so that our readers can feel like they're witnesses to these events.
好，那当然呢，我们就必须要提供足够的这些细节陈述，来让你的读者觉得，哎，可以很清楚的了解这个例子。
Right, so now let's take a look about what we can put in body paragraph one.
好，首先呢，我们先从第一个主体段落开始。
And so over here, we're going to have an example about a loose button on my shirt.
好，首先你可以先举个例子说，哦，这个哦，衣服上面的个扣子呢，哦，好像变松了。
And so then, what we can say about it is first that I did not fix the button.
那关于这件事，我们可以提到哪些细节呢？首先，我们先提到的就是，哎，一开始发现扣子松了的时候，没有马上去把这个问题解决。
And then the result is that I had to sew the whole button back on when it fell off.
哦，而造成的结果呢，也就是我当它整个扣子都掉下来的时候，我必须把整颗扣子再缝回去。
And in our second body paragraph, we're going to write an example that is much more modern. And this example will relate to the computer problem that we discussed earlier.
好，那到了第二个主体段落的时候呢，我们要举一个比较现代化的例子了。那这个例子呢，就是老师刚刚提到的，哦，从他的电脑里发出怪声的这件事。
All right, and so then after we have these funny noises, I realized that the fan was broken.
好，那发出怪声的时候呢，老师发现原来是电脑的风扇坏了。
And then we're going to narrate the events that happened. So after the fan was broken, it got very hot.
好，我们让这个事件变得更加的明确清晰呢。哦，那既然这个风扇坏了，哦，电脑本身的主机呢就越来越热。
All right. And then another one of the key events that happened is my friend told me something scary about how the computer would get really hot and it would corrupt the data.
好，那接下来提到的呢，哦，就是哎，老师的朋友呢有告诉他一些哦，关于说电脑过热却没有处理的时候会造成什么样的影响哦，这样恐怖的事。
All right, and so then as a result, I set up a fan to blow into my computer to cool it down.
好，那因此呢，老师呢就赶快架设了电风扇哦，来把这个风呢哦吹进电脑里头。
All right, so now after we have these ideas in the two body paragraphs outlined out, we're going to move on and outline our conclusion.
好，那既然我们现在主体段落也已经完成它的大纲了，现在呢，我们来看一看结论的部分。
And so in this conclusion, we're going to re-emphasize the thesis, and we're going to do this by saying that I must say the main point of what I learned first, which is I must stop procrastinating.
好，那在这个结论的部分呢，首先先提到最重要的这个重点，也就是我必须要停止拖延。
Right, and then we're going to reiterate the proverb that we mentioned at the beginning, a stitch in time saves nine. We're going to say it's a great piece of advice.
好，那接下来我们要再呼应一下一开始提到的这句格言。那我们会说，哎，这句格言哦，防微杜渐是非常好的一个忠告。
And then finally, we're going to finish off by explaining what we learned from this experience, which is I hope I can follow this proverb's advice more often.
最后呢，当然要提到说我们从这些经验中学到了些什么。那这里呢，可以写到说，哦，我希望我从此之后可以好好的遵循这个格言。
Right, so now we have an outline, and we can use this outline to write a composition. But before we show you the composition that we wrote, we're going to take a little bit of a break.
好，我们现在呢，大纲已经完成了。那我们既然有了大纲，就可以来写我们的写作范例了。不过呢，我们在这个看写作范例之前，先休息一下。待会儿回来，我们再为各位同学讲解。
All right, welcome back. What we're going to do in this part of the lesson is show you the writing motto. And so this is the essay that we wrote about a stitch in time saves nine.
好，那欢迎各位同学回来。现在呢，我们要为各位同学来讲解写作范例。那这个的写作范例呢，哦，我们讲的这个题目呢，就是根据我们刚刚讲的格言“防微杜渐”啊，来写出来的一篇文章。
A stitch in time saves nine. A common proverb is "A stitch in time saves nine." Literally.This means that if you sew up a small tear right away, it will only take one stitch. But if you wait, it may take nine stitches to mend the tear.
有句话说“防微杜渐”，字面上来说，意思是指只要有小缺口，马上缝合，只需要一针。但如果耽搁了，就需要九针才能修补这个缺口。
More generally,This proverb means that you can save yourself a lot of trouble if you take care of your problems as soon as they occur.
通常这句俗谚意味着问题发生的时候马上解决就可以省下很多的麻烦。
I have many experiences that make me believe that a stitch in time saves nine is a really good piece of advice.
在诸多的经验之中，防微杜渐让我相信它是一个很棒的忠告。
The first experience is similar to the literal meaning of the proverb. Sometimes when I'm getting dressed, I see that there is a button loose on one of my shirts. I should just grab a needle and thread and fix it right then with one or two stitches.
第一个经验跟字面上的意思非常相似。有时当我在穿衣服的时候，看到衬衫上的纽扣松脱了，我当下应该就拿起针线，用一两针就可以修补好。
But I always seem to have something more pressing to do, so I put it off. Then when I get home in the evening, I forget about the loose button, or I feel too tired to take care of it, so I put it off some more.
但我总是觉得有很多事情紧急要做，因此我就耽搁了。晚上当我回家时，我忘记纽扣松掉的事情，或是太疲倦了，现在不想处理，因此我又继续耽搁了。
The end result is that the button falls off and I have to sew the whole thing back on, which takes a lot longer than it would have if I had just fixed the button when it was loose.
而结果就是整颗纽扣掉了，我必须将它整颗缝回去。整个过程比起当初只是修补松掉的纽扣，又需花掉更多的时间。
Another experience concerns my computer. It started making funny noises one day. It sounded like the fan was having a problem.
另外一次的经验则跟电脑有关。电脑一开始发出一些怪声，似乎是风扇出了些问题。
But I just ignored it until the sound went away. But I noticed that the top of my computer started to feel really hot. And when I took a DVD out of the disk drive, it was really hot too.
但是我一直无视它，一直到它声音消失。可是我发现电脑的顶部非常的烫。当我从磁碟机拿出光碟时，连光碟都一样是烫的。
Then a friend told me, "Oh, your computer will get really hot if the fan is broken. You can cook an egg on it. you'd better not use it very long each time.
接着有个朋友告诉我，如果风扇坏掉了，电脑会变得很烫，你都可以在上面煎蛋了，最好每次不要用太久哦。
But what got me even more scared was when another friend said, if your computer gets too hot, it will corrupt all your data. Then I got really scared.
但我让我更加害怕的是另一位朋友所说的，如果你电脑太烫，你的资料会坏掉哦。之后我就真的害怕了。
I wanted to take my computer to the shop to have the fan fixed right away, but I couldn't afford to be without it for 2 days. I had a tight deadline to meet, so I really needed to use my computer.
我想马上拿它去店里修理，但我没有办法忍受两天没有电脑。我有一件快截止的事情要做，我真的需要我的电脑。
But I was so scared of losing data that I opened the computer case up and I set up a fan to blow right into the computer whenever I used it. Fortunately, my computer held up until I finished my project.
但我真的害怕会失去我的资料，所以我把电脑外盖打开，装了一台电扇，把风吹进去。幸好在完成企划之前，这台电脑撑住了。
All these experiences make me realize that I must stop procrastinating.
这些经验让我了解到，我必须要停止拖延。
I really should have taken care of my computer the first time I heard a funny noise come out of it, and I really should fix my buttons as soon as I see that one is loose.
在第一次听到那怪声从电脑发出来时，我应该马上处理；而看到纽扣松脱时，我也真的应该马上缝好它。
I know that a stitch in time saves nine is a great piece of advice. I just hope that I can follow it more often in the future.
我了解到防微杜渐真的是一个好的忠告。我只希望以后我都可以遵照这个忠告好好的生活。
All right, so now let's take some time and learn a bit more about Proverbs. And we're going to take a look at some of the exercises in your textbook. And you can find the exercises on page 247 to 248.
好，那我们刚刚呢已经看到了这篇写作范例了。那接下来的时间呢，我们会花在教导各位同学更多的所谓的格言跟谚语。那这个部分呢，我们要带各位同学来做个练习。各位同学如果手边有课本的话，请看到课本第247页到248页。
Right, and these proverbs are ones that contradict other proverbs. And so we're going to discuss what these proverbs mean and then find another proverb that has an opposite meaning.
好，这个练习很有趣哦，它是希望你找出它相对意义的格言哦。那我们会先讨论一下每一个格言是代表什么意思，那接下来找出一个格言可以去配对它，去表示的是它的相反的意思。
Right, and the first proverb that we're going to take a look at is proverb number one, and it's a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush.
好，我们首先呢，先看一下第一个这个格言哦。那这格言的意思是说，一鸟在手胜过二鸟在林。
And so this means that if you caught some bird or you have something now, it's better to just keep it than to let it loose in the hope that you might get something more, like two extra birds that are in the bush but haven't been caught yet.
好，那这句格言它真正的意思是说呢，当你抓到一只鸟的时候，你就应该牢牢地把它抓好，而不是呢为了去追捕在这个树林里面的另外两只鸟，而把这手上的这只鸟呢，给放走了。
Right, and then a proverb that has an opposite meaning could be one like nothing ventured, nothing gained. And this means basically that if you don't try to do something new or if you don't try to do something that you haven't accomplished yet, you won't be successful.
好，那跟这个格言相反的意思呢，我们也许可以选择这个也就是你不冒险的话，你就不会得到任何事情。那我们刚刚提到过说，一只鸟在手上的时候呢，你就应该抓牢它，而不是盲目的再去追求另外的两只鸟。那但是呢，如果说你觉得不去冒险，怎么可以得到更多的话，那你很有可能就会失去手上这一只鸟。因此呢，我们就选择这个谚语来当做它相反意义的谚语。
Right, let's take a look at one more proverb.And this one says, fools rush in where angels fear to tread.
好，我们下一个看到的谚语呢，它的字面上的意思是说，只有傻瓜会冲进连天使都不愿冲进的地方。
All right, and so basically this means that you should be cautious. You shouldn't take too many chances. And should look carefully before you do something new.
好，那它的意思当然就是说，你真是个傻瓜啊，那连天使都不愿意去了。当然意思就是请你要呢做事的时候必须要想得更仔细，更加的小心，不要这么盲目的去做一些冲动的决定。
And then we have a very different proverb, which is he who hesitates is lost.
好，那我们可以看到跟它完全相反意思的一个谚语呢，讲到的是哦，一个迟疑的人就会失去事情。
Right, now let's come back and talk about your homework for this lesson. And so what we hope you do is you review the material in this unit, and then you do the rest of the proverb exercise and the writing analysis exercise.
好，我们现在呢，请各位同学啊，我们来想想这个整个学期最后的一个练习。那各位同学回去要再看一看这一课的单元，那把所有的文法练习跟写作练习都完成。
And then you can do the writing activity, which is to write your own essay based on one of the proverbs in this chapter.
好，那在写作实习的部分呢，我们在课本的最后条列出非常多的一些的这谚语格言。那各位同学呢，可以选择一个来写作你自己的范例文。
And you can write about a stitch in time saves nine, or you can write about another proverb that you find interesting.
好，那当然，各位同学，如果对于防微杜渐这一个谚语很有兴趣，你还是可以写这个谚语，或者呢，你可以再找寻你觉得特别有兴趣的谚语来写作。
Right. Now, we enjoyed teaching you during these last two semesters of English composition. We hope you learned a lot and that you've improved your writing through this process.
好，我们希望呢，各位同学啊，在这一整个学年之中哦，学习到了更多的英文作文的写作了。
And we just want to point out a few things that we want you to remember before we leave.
好，那既然今天是最后一次跟各位同学在这节目中相见了，那我们希望呢能够再把一些重点再提出来，请各位同学要记得。
And the first is that writing is hard work. It takes a lot of preparation, takes organization and planning in order to write well. So make sure that you take time to prepare before you begin writing.
好，首先要提醒各位同学的是呢，写作这件事本身就是非常困难的事情，一个过程哦。所以呢，各位同学需要花一点时间去组织、去架构，然后再开始写。也就是提醒各位同学哦，在开始写作前，一定要先做准备。
And now, when you are preparing, you should decide what is the purpose for the key message of your writing.
好，那当你呢在准备的时候，最重要的当然就是要决定你写这篇文章的目的哦，或者是你写这篇文章的重点是什么。
Right. Now, after you decide on your purpose, write down the most important information that you need to put into your essay to convince your readers to accept your purpose.
好，那在你决定你的写作目的之后呢，接下来应该把最重要的一些资讯都写下来。这些资讯呢，是要能够去说服你的读者的。
So now, if you're writing a short email, it's okay just to write down one or two phrases as you prepare.But if you're going to write a longer, more complex report, it's better to take the time and prepare an outline, a long outline that's full of details before you begin writing. And the more work that you put into your preparation, the easier it will be to write your paper later.
好，那当然，如果各位同学只是写作短篇的这个 email 的话呢，几个句子就够了。那如果是整篇的文章呢，当然就是要进行所谓条列大纲的部分。那这也代表说，你的准备工作呢可能会更加的多。
Right, and one final thing to remember is it takes more than one try to write well. So make sure you check over your writing before you turn it in.
好，那接下来各位同学一定要再提醒你们，写作不是一试就成的哦，所以呢，一定要花时间在做检讨跟整理。
Right, thank you for joining us for this semester of English composition, and we wish you the best of luck in your continuing studies and in your careers.
谢谢各位同学这一整个学期的参与，我们希望各位同学能够好好的在英文作文继续增进，并且继续学习。